Hello and goodbye, July. This month went by as quick as all the other months do, and unfortunately I don't have anything to show for it, but I'll tell you why. As I mentioned last month, I was sick for a couple weeks and that kind of set me back. I'm the type of person that if I don't keep my momentum going, I lose all motivation and I lose any momentum I had and just gotta start over. So that's kind of where I've been, just trying to get back on doing something. Also throwing me off track last week, I lost the AC in my house and it was like 80 degrees and super stuffy in here. So I ended up living back with my parents for the last week basically. So that was like going back to when I was a quarter century old, but it was fun. AC's working again. I can't get it to shut off now. So sorry if you can hear that. I've also been busily training for my 10K that I'm doing in September. So every other day, basically I've been running a 5K and I'm doing, you know, another workout regimen. I told you about the hardcore 22, I think last month, and I'm doing that like 6 days a week. So it's been taking up a lot of my free time. So I've been working a little bit on my videos, but not as much as I'd like to. Still more stuff on the way, still working on the Japan videos, which I'm actually gonna put on the back burner here. And you know how I've got all these things just juggling all at once. It's so many things on the back burner, but the Japan videos are going to the back burner because I want to do something different for the next video. Go back to doing a review will be the next video. So look forward to that. Hopefully the next video, that's the idea. I was about a quarter of the way through the next Japan music video and it's really cool, but it's gonna be a lot of intricate little cuts, kind of like the one I did for Robot Restaurant. So it's a time consuming process and I figured I could probably rush it and get it out this month, but I don't want to rush it. So the other thing I considered doing was releasing my album finally this month, but I was looking at it actually this morning and I just don't feel like I can release something that hurts my ears to listen to just because the sound quality is not, I mean, it's not mastered correctly. I'm gonna try, and since it's all flattened and I can't, you know, go back and master it properly, I'm gonna go see what I can do to mess with some EQ and some junk, try and make it sound better. Probably next month on the album. So despite my best efforts, I got nothing out for you this month. I'm really sorry about that because it's been a really good year from beginning to now, you know, weekly videos there until the end of April and then a video a month-ish, and now nothing this month. So I'm sorry about that, but I really do hope to have new video or videos next month, including a game review I'm working on right now. Working on it, presently. As soon as I'm done editing this, I'm gonna be working on it. So it's in the early stages, so you know, I usually try to take about a month on those. It could go a little longer. Hopefully next month I'll have it for you. Also coming up this next month, gonna record the next episode of Game Game Show Ultra, gonna have special guests on it, and it should be really fun. So stay tuned for that. That probably won't be out next month, probably out in September, so stay tuned. I talked to Andrew about the podcast. He's been hosting the podcast as it's been, and it's been down for months now, unfortunately. He's thinking we need to find another method, obviously, of hosting those or something. So I've had some of you, you know, give us some suggestions. I'm open again to suggestions. I've heard SoundCloud was a possibility. I'm just trying to think, like, you know, I don't really know how it works. Can you like get that on your iPod, or how do you guys listen to the podcast? I could consider uploading them to YouTube, but I don't want to kind of flood my channel with, you know, my past like 30 episodes of just, you know, nothing but audio. Maybe I could do like a audio video kind of one, but I don't know. That is even more complicated, and you know how I am with time. So please give me your suggestions below on what you think I should do with the podcast as far as hosting it, format, that kind of stuff. Should it go on YouTube? Should it go on SoundCloud? What should I do with it? I don't know. Don't want to abandon it. I mean, people like it. You know, the people that listen to are really big fans of it, and I appreciate that. I really wish that I could do it more often. It's just we hit that technical snag. It's like, why bother recording them if we can't put it up? So all ears for your guys' suggestions. That's really all I have for this month. I mean, obviously I have nothing for this month and I do feel bad about that, but this last month when I was sick, going into this month, I actually played some games, you guys. I never get to play games, so this was actually really cool for me. I mentioned I was nearly done with Mighty No. 9 last month, and I finished it shortly after that, and I gotta say, I thought it was a pretty good game. I mean, it is basically like Mega Man. Now, it's not exactly the same. I still think it's good. It's definitely in the same vein. I know they didn't get the best scores and that kind of stuff, but I enjoyed it. I thought it was a good game. I think it's worth checking out. If you like Mega Man, peep it. Also beat, I think it was the same day, started and finished Gone Home, which, you know, it's a short game. So kind of like one of those adventure game, point and click kind of things. And usually not my kind of game. And it was actually good. I mean, the way they tell the story is brilliant. But you know, it was a fine game, although it's not my type of game because I'm more action oriented and point and click is just not my thing. I only like a couple point and click games, although it was very good. I think the same day, Metal Gear Solid 5 Ground Zeroes, I'd had it for a long time and my girlfriend bought me the next Metal Gear 5, which I haven't played yet. It's like, well, I gotta play this first. And I'd read, you know, you you could get through the game in 2 hours. I was like, that doesn't sound quite right. No, you can. And it did not take long at all to get through it, but there's plenty of replay value to go back and like find the hidden tapes or whatever and that kind of stuff. So I was thinking about going back and doing that, or maybe I should just go to the next one because I really want to see, you know, the next, well, or the last Metal Gear 5. We'll see. Also, somewhere around that time, I also beat Axiom Verge. Fantastic game. If you like Metroid or Metroidvania games, that kind of stuff, it is a lot like Metroid. I mean, it is so like Metroid. I would highly recommend it. Currently, I am playing Kirby's Robobot Land. Is that right? Yep, Kirby Robobot Land on 3DS. Got the new 3DS. Don't have an exclusive game for that yet. Enjoying that. It's a lot like Kirby's Triple Double or whatever it was called. I can't even remember. Triple Deluxe, I guess. So very similar to that, but you ride in robots and stuff. It's a fun Kirby game. I enjoy it. Also playing EDF 4.1, of course. There's endless hours to play that game. I mean, it's gonna keep me busy for years and I can't stop playing it because it's still fun. And of course, like everybody else, I've been playing Pokemon Go. I was late to get onto it. I mean, I guess I downloaded it when it first came out, but then I didn't really do anything with it. You gotta like walk around and do this. I don't have time for that. I walk super fast and I didn't figure out about the AR mode. You know, I was like, you can't like really walk fast and like catch Pokemon if you have the AR mode on. Turn it off and then you can pretty much go on a walk. I've actually been going on runs and playing Pokemon Go. And you'd like to think that people don't judge you for playing Pokemon Go when you're like 33, but they totally do. And I'm like running and doing the familiar motion of, you know, trying to catch Pokeballs and running my 5K or whatever and looking over and people have a big grin on their face like, you giant nerd. I'm like, yeah, I got more Pokemon than you though, so deal with it. Really enjoying that game. Obviously, there's all kinds of technical problems and things that would make the game better, but I've been really enjoying it because I like to go for walks a lot, you know, breaks at work and that kind of stuff. And I'm finding that I'm getting more steps on my Fitbit just by playing the game. So I think obviously there's been some bad things that have come of it, but I think there's a lot of potential for good things to come of it. And you know, I guess the guy that caught all the Pokemon said he lost 10 pounds or something like that. Whether that's true or not, I don't know, but I could totally see that. Getting kids out of their house and doing things they probably wouldn't normally do. I think it's a positive thing. I enjoy Pokemon Go. Go get the Pokemon. If you're a naysayer and you're like, you know, I like Pokemon, but all these people playing this stupid game, just try it. Give it a shot. I think it's a lot of fun. I just got Brandon into it yesterday. He's like, man, this is stupid. And then he texted me earlier. He's like, you got me playing this game in Walmart, man. So anyway, I think it's cool. Peep it. Pickups I've forgotten for like the last couple months. Here they are. I just picked up Lunar Silver Star Story Complete, which I remember when I first started working at a used video game store, I saw this. I was like, oh my gosh, this looks amazing. And it was amazing. And it was priced pretty fairly, I suppose. And then the price has just skyrocketed. And I found this for a pretty fair price, actually, considering it's complete, save the pins that come with it. I didn't even know it came with pins because I rented it. Of course, I don't have pins in it, but it's got the cloth map and the soundtrack and everything. Really want to play this, but of course, this is from the age of really, really long RPGs, so I don't know when I'm practically gonna have a chance to play it, but I wanna play it, and then I'll play Lunar 2. Just yesterday, picked this up, PQ, is Practical Intelligence Quotient. I think there's other games in the series or something like that, or I don't know. This guy that I just bought this from said that he had to import this. He didn't realize it came out here, so looks like a cool puzzle game on PSP. Dragon Spirit on Famicom. I already own this game on Nintendo, but I just thought it would be cool to have it on Famicom. The soundtrack, as I remember, was really freaking good on this. I know that, like, the first stage or something. Yeah, this is a shooter, isn't it? I think this is what I think it is. But if it is what I think it is, awesome soundtrack. Really, really good. And I got Sonic CD, which I'm not sure how I got that because I don't have a Sega CD. Oh, wait. My cousin was nice enough to give me his old Sega CD because they just found it and they're like, oh, I never played this. Wonder if Eric would like it. So obviously it's got a Sega Genesis as well with Sonic 2. Yeah. And Sega CD. It didn't come with the plug-in, so I also bought a AV cable, which does not work because that's for the older Genesis, and I think this is the newer Genesis, so I dunced it. But anyway, looking forward to getting this working so I can play some Sonic CD. Oops. That's all I have for this month. I will see you next month, back with new stuff, I'm hoping. Sorry about this month. Pew, see you next month.